And by converting those classic iconic vehicles, we're maintaining those classics on the road. So both being sustainable and in taking the original chassis and renovating that to a standard which matches, if not betters, the standard of the car off the production line when it was first built. We ostensibly take iconic classic vehicles, the poster child of everybody's youth, and we keep them on the road for the future. And by converting those classic iconic vehicles, we're maintaining those classics on the road. So both being sustainable and in taking the original chassis and renovating that to a standard which matches, if not betters, the standard of the car off the production line when it was first built. But in addition to that, fitting a modern OEM validated electric powertrain.
At Everrati, all the way down to the individual engineers working here, we all love cars. You know, all of us have an instant grin when we see an old classic or, you know, hear the roar of a V8. But in the reality we live in, you know, fossil fuels are being phased out, and it is essential that we all play our part to achieve a sustainable future, to reach net zero. So, you know, for the guys like me who love cars and just want to keep them on the road, this is what we have to do to be responsible in today's times, but to retain that love for cars and to ensure that, like, future generations can enjoy that too.
First of all, undertake a feasibility study against any application. So we take an original vehicle that we source for development purposes. We scan that, do a complete 3D scan, both internally and externally. And we then utilize that within our CAD system and within SolidWorks to first of all package our existing technology that we've validated to understand how best we can utilize the spaces in the vehicle to give us the product that we need.
The most important considerations to Everrati when converting a classic car is to produce a quality product that drivers will enjoy. A lot of this enjoyment factor comes from preserving the original characteristic of the car as far as possible. Some of the ways we seek to achieve this is by taking original corner weights of the car, establishing its original center of gravity, and then in our SolidWorks software, we replicate this. Once we've decided where to mount each of the units within our package, we can tweak these positions until the center of gravity is as close to the original car as possible. What this means is that we end up with a product that feels and drives the way the original car should have, but in an improved way. For example, we normally upgrade the brakes and the suspension, so you still get the same handling characteristics, but we include modern safety features and some comfort features where necessary.
As a startup business, I think the financial pressures of a startup business are always really, really key. So one of the great things that we had in working with DTE and with the SolidWorks team was to get onto the startup scheme. I think that really gave us a good starting point. It wasn't just that for us. I think, you know, with my past experience, I've utilized numerous different CAD packages over my many years. The other key thing that really made a difference for us was looking out there in the marketplace and seeing where people's expertise was. So it's a balance of a CAD system at a sufficient level to give us what we needed in terms of developing the integrated package that we wanted, but also then giving us the opportunity to take on board some really experienced CAD engineers that were able to hit the ground running and get us started very, very quickly.
SolidWorks is instrumental to every phase of the engineering process, from the original feasibility study all the way through to aesthetic enhancements, which can be chosen as bespoke for clients' specific needs. For example, we use SolidWorks to design and structurally test our mounting for batteries and transmissions, but we also use it for finishing the interior of the vehicles. For example, we designed a bespoke indicator surround for the steering wheel of the Series 2 Land Rover, which was trimmed in leather and set the steering wheel off perfectly.
The great thing about developing our own platforms for these cars are, as new technology comes along, we have the package spaces and the systems already in place. As like those new batteries and new motors come along, we can update our vehicles to extend the range, give them more power, make them more drivable. As we'll have full assemblies of these cars in SolidWorks, if a customer does ask for a more bespoke feature, aircon on a Series 2 Land Rover, we have the package space to be able to design those in. At the minute, 3D experience is really helpful for a cloud storage space for us, meaning any of us can access the files wherever we are. It's also a really good tool for allowing the rest of the company, not just the engineer designers, to see the files. It means they can log on and see, review a part through something like 3D Play without having to have full download of SolidWorks. As Everrati grows and we expand into markets like America, having a cloud-based system like 3D Experience will allow our team to much more easily collaborate.
This will help everybody see one version of the car we're working on and be able to work from wherever they are to get the job done.
I think just the attention to detail and the quality, coming back to the components that we use, the approach that we take in terms of the systems and process internally, really takes a lot from experience that I've been fortunate to have at some of the OEM businesses. It makes it a very robust process and ensures that the vehicles that we give to our customers are quality and they're right first time. I think what sets us apart as well is some of that approach in terms of developing platforms for our vehicles that are able to give us the opportunity to quickly develop new applications going forwards. So with the initial development work and validation work we've done on our current vehicles, so the Porsche and on the Series 2 Land Rover and also the GT40, the development work we've done there will stand us in good stead for future applications too, and again ensure that we've got a quality product that we give to our customer. Where we like to excel, because we take a car from the ground up and we renovate it from right back to bare metal and then bring the car back up to a high level of quality, it's the full deal, it's the full integration, and that enables us to produce something which is really, really special. The fit and finish and the final the details that we apply to the cars really stand us out there in the marketplace. My favorite car to work on in Everrati, I think, has to be the Porsche so far. I think from some of the reviews we've had, certainly the analog feel and the braking, the steering feel, the handling of the car is something that we've not really disturbed. So very, very proud of that, and proud of the team that's delivered it too.
With any new system, there's a lot of learning to do. So DT were great with one getting us all on a training course to get us up to speed. Some of the non-engineers as well who wouldn't have seen it, get them up to speed on using 3D Experience, from running training courses through to helping with any issues that we've had and getting us running.
It's been a very good relationship with DTE. We've got our own dedicated account manager that the team work with whenever we need them. They're always just at the end of a phone call, but also in looking to the future as well. We're now at a stage where we're developing our systems and process into a more consolidated physical digital system. I think the support from DTE will really stand us in good stead in terms of integrating our PLM system, as it were, into our broader business systems in the future. I think we've got a very exciting year coming up. We've taken our Porsche and our Series 2 to production now. So we're consolidating our production methodologies, consolidating our production partners to move that forward. So that's going to be a real, really big achievement this year. The one big exciting thing for this year, I think, is the GT40. That's our collective poster child, I think, in terms of the car that we all want to show to the public and to show to our customers. It will be absolutely an amazing vehicle. So I think that's our plan for this year. And then, we can get that done. I'm sure there's lots more to come in the following years beyond that.